Welcome back, everyone. Robin here, and thank you for joining me to look at some of the new features and enhancements that have been added to Final Cut Pro version 10.7. So this is just one of a series of tutorials on the topic as opposed to one big long one. So if you missed any of the others, just check the channel for the 10.7 playlist or click up here. And as always, if you like what you see and find something in this or any of my other videos helpful, maybe give us a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button to not miss future videos. It really helps the channel. Oh, and with each and every update, be sure to watch this video up here to see how to update Final Cut Pro safely, including your projects and libraries, because just the application, as some have been suggesting, isn't enough to give you a way back if something goes wrong. This time we want to look at the new feature that allows you to collapse any number of linked clips into a nice and tidy linked storyline. This is a great feature to reduce visual clutter and organize everything in your timeline more clearly. Let's have a look. So, I don't know how you edit things into your timeline, in particular how you edit cutaways and B-roll, but this is something I see a lot in other people's timelines. A nice Tetris slash Jenga style organization of clips and other media. Oddly overlapping clips and maybe even secondary storylines. The problem with this is that you end up stacking your timeline unnecessarily, making it much harder to navigate and really understand what's going on by just looking at it. I've always wondered about this since, to me, it makes little practical nor visual sense. I suspect it will mostly happen to people used to working with a track-based editor where overriding clips is possible no matter where they sit. So they'll probably edit their primary, then look into their event for B-roll, maybe choosing a longer selection than they needed in the end because why not? Position the playhead where they want to connect it, or in the case of a track-based editor where they wanted to edit it into V2 or V3, etc., and hit Q to connect it. Rinse and repeat while going back each time to look for the desired edit point that may not connect directly to the clip before it, so end up above it, which I've seen lead to this sort of thing, even if I'm exaggerating a bit for demonstration purposes, but not much. These sorts of edits, assuming there is no transparency involved, such as with a picture-in-picture, don't really make any sense since everything within the overlap isn't visible anyway. So why have any of the superfluous material in the timeline? And how could you clean it up easily? Well, until now, if you wanted to go back to clean things up into a nice, only what is visible edit, you really only had three options, none of which were great. The laziest would be to select all the clips, right-click and select New Compound Clip or hit Option G. Give it a name and hit OK. And there you go, clean, organized timeline. But to access the clips and actual edit, you'd have to double-click the compound to open it, make changes out of context with your main project, and jump back. Ugh, yeah, not exactly practical in a case like this. I'll undo. The second, more brute force option would be to select everything and then either right-click and select Overwrite to the primary storyline or hit Option Command down arrow. And while that would cleanly truncate anything that doesn't need to be there into a nice clean edit in the primary, that of course overrides anything in the primary that was there before, aside from maybe its audio, which also isn't exactly practical nor what you probably want in many cases. You lose any and all flexibility should you want to go back and tweak just your B-roll without changing the primary edit. I'll undo that too. So, again, until now, if you, like me, just wanted a nicely cropped version of your B-roll cut in the timeline, maintain the needed flexibility of the edit, and wanted the advantages that having it in a secondary storyline gives you, you'd have to manually edit each clip's in and or out point so that they didn't overlap anymore. After that, you could select all the clips that are now on the same level, right-click and choose Create Storyline, or simply hit Command-G. Phew. All that for just a little cleanup and better timeline organization. Well, of course, that is no more. Now, as of Final Cut Pro version 10.7, this whole process has become much easier. Literally just a single click. If I select all the connected clips once again, of which at least two have to be overlapping, and the selection can't contain audio-only clips, by the way, and right-click on any one of them, scrolling to the bottom, we now see a brand new command, Collapse to Connected Storyline. If I select this, or press the now new keyboard shortcut Shift and not Option Command downward arrow, et voila, all the clips collapse into a neat and tidy connected storyline without overriding anything below it and getting rid of all the superfluous material. Really nice. Of course, keep in mind that just as when you overwrite clips with audio into the primary, collapsing clips into a secondary storyline also retains the audio as it was before the collapse. In other words, while the video portions of the clips are truncated to the visible sections according to the top-down rule, or whatever is on top wins, the respective audio stays as it was before the collapse. Easily demonstrated by selecting everything in the storyline and either showing the audio lanes or right-clicking and selecting Expand Audio or hitting Ctrl-S. Makes perfect sense to me, and I think that's really clever. And I don't know if anyone noticed, but in previous versions, if you had a connected storyline that contained a gap clip, such as these, and you did the only thing you could do, namely override it to the primary, even though a gap clip isn't an actual clip, it's just emptiness, it would still overwrite whatever was previously visible in the primary. Not great. But this too has been fixed. Now if you overwrite a gap clip to either the primary or to the new secondary storylines, Final Cut will intelligently recognize if something below a gap clip is and should be visible and keep it that way. Great improvement. By the way, a little heads up and something I actually forgot to mention in my video about the scrolling timeline, namely that there are also new mappable shortcuts for both features. Ironically, I have not seen anyone point this out, not even mentioned the already existing shortcut for the collapsing feature. And maybe you're not seeing it either. Because if you're using a custom keyboard layout, which apparently everyone is, you won't in fact see the new shortcut, since new ones are only added to the standard keyboard layout, not any existing custom layouts. Which actually kind of makes sense, too, if you think about it. So if you aren't seeing it either because you, too, are using a custom layout or just want to reassign it to something else, just hit Option-Command-K to open the command editor, and with the layout selected that you'd like to add it to, enter Collapse into the search field, and there you go. You're shown the new command for collapsing into a secondary that you can select and either assign the missing Shift Command downward arrow, or assign it to whatever keyboard shortcut you prefer. I'll just assign it to F7, close the command editor, and now I can simply hit my shortcut as opposed to having to right-click every time I want to collapse any connected clips. And as I mentioned, the same goes for the scrolling timeline. Enter scrolling to find the command, and again you can assign whatever shortcut, I'll assign it to F8, to turn the scrolling timeline on or off on the fly without having to go into the settings. And by the way, I hope, logically, it goes without saying that you have to pay attention to what you are including into the collapse secondary. You probably don't want to include title overlays, for example, since these obviously have transparency that Final Cut can't account for or take into consideration, which will, of course, result in something undesirable, such as this. Nothing but title. Oopsie.
So, a great new organizational addition to Final Cut's already unique and powerful toolset,
for keeping things tidy and organized in your timeline. Another one of those things Apple manages to give me that I never realized I both needed and wanted. And while it seems so simple, it is super smart and helpful in speeding up edits and keeping them super clean. Do you agree? Let me know down in the comments. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Thanks again for watching. And again, if you liked what you saw and learned something, maybe consider showing your appreciation by clicking the like button and even subscribing. Also, click the bell to make sure you don't miss out on the upcoming updates and tips and tricks videos I have lined up. Or maybe one of these videos has what you're looking for. Take care, and I hope to see you in the next one.